When you request a URL and hit enter, the browser sends a request to the server. For example, we can simulate this right on the command line. Once the browser receives the response, which is the HTML we see here, it must somehow convert all of the markup into something that we see on the screen here. Ever wonder how that happens?
You know, now that you mention it, it does feel a little bit like magic.
It's not magic. The browser follows a well-defined set of steps, and it all starts with processing the HTML and building the DOM. The HTML specification contains a set of rules for how we should process the received data. For example, the text contained within the angle brackets has special meaning in HTML and is set to be a tag. As a result, whenever we encounter a tag, the browser emits a token. In this case, it is the StartTagHTML token. Next, we would get the StartTag head token, and so on. This entire process is done by the tokenizer. And while the tokenizer is doing this work, there's another process that is consuming these tokens and is converting them to node objects. For example, we convert the first HTML token and create the HTML node. Then we consume the next token and create the head node.
Is there a relationship between the nodes?
Yes. Notice that the tokenizer emits start and end tokens, which tells us the relationship between the nodes. The start tag head token comes before end tag HTML token, which tells us that the head token is a child of HTML. Similarly, the meta and link nodes are children of the head node, and so on. Eventually, once we consume all of the tokens, we arrive at the document object model, or simply DOM, which is a tree structure that captures the content and properties of the HTML and all the relationships between the nodes.
Cool. So we've converted the HTML to the document object model. It's pretty easy to see why it's called the DOM tree.
Yeah, also, note that these objects contain all of their properties. For example, the image node has a source attribute, and this node right here would also have the same property. The DOM is the full parse representation of the HTML markup.
Okay, so we downloaded all the HTML and built the DOM. Got it. All right, what's next?
Actually, the browser constructs the DOM incrementally, and you can take advantage of this to speed up the rendering of your pages. In fact, this is something that the Google search pages do really, really well. Let me show you.